Well, believe it or not, today is January 30th, and yesterday it was nice. Today's supposed to be nicer. I was out here working the back of the property. I'm gonna turn all this into our garden area. Used to be just woods, and I cut these down quite a few years ago and been putting leaves and debris back here, you know, like cut down trees and limbs, a few closet doors and a couple bad things. I pretty much pulled those out, separated those, because I don't want that stuff in my soil. Pretty much everything over here is as clean as it can get. And I'm gonna turn all this into garden area. What's really great about it is yesterday I was able to work an area over here where I'm gonna put potatoes with the rake. And that was on January 29th, 2016. Real mild spring, actually winter, but feels like a spring. We only had a few snowfalls and I don't mind it one bit. So I've been doing all the stuff pretty much by hand. And this is an area called Cowboy Town. Right there you see that big fire pit, which I'm actually gonna remove. I built this thing probably 10 years ago. I'm gonna take it all apart after I'm done burning this stuff and rebuild it somewhere out here, because this is the view. I'm gonna eventually build a little tiny house, a little tiny cabin or something, but I'll be looking across the garden and we'll be able to have our own food and see how that goes. It should be great. Up this area, this is mostly where my orchard is gonna be, up that way towards that trailer. That trailer won't be there in the summer because we use it and it'll be up front. But I've been pruning this tree too. This is the oldest apple tree on the property and it's been neglected for quite a few years, but I'm slowly working it down. Today I should be able to get it the rest of the way I want it. See all those suckers up top? Well, this is what I did yesterday. Trimmed it. Should have some excellent apple growth. And this is the oldest tree in the orchard. This was here. See how nice these ones are? Then they'll be able to get heavy and drop down here. Now it's gonna be tough to keep the deer out of all this stuff, but we'll manage. I'll figure it out. All this stuff here is gonna go. That's all old firewood from old trees. I'm gonna pile them up somewhere else. A lot of them I'm gonna use to make, I'll stack them in the woods on the other side of where the wheelbarrow is. And I'm gonna drill holes on the ends and they can be for the mason bees that are always around here. They're native, where the honeybees are not native to the United States, they're native to Europe. So honeybees, while they're great in producing honey, the mason bees are more effective, more efficient, and they pollinate way better than any honeybee can. And we already have them here, so I'm just gonna create homes for them by drilling holes in the ends of these logs. I have some bigger ones back there. I'm gonna stack them up on the edge of the woods. Give them a nice home and a lot of food for them to eat. And once my tree is done here, that's gonna be awesome. And then I have some other trees that I've been planting. Apples, pears, cherry, peach. And they're tiny right now, but I'm gonna have to get into some bigger ones here and get those in the ground too. So that's what I'm doing. Just prepping this here in January 2016. Get these fires going again, because I gotta get all this leftover brush burnt and get this ash spread out over the growing area. So that's the goal today. Even though some of these chunks are frozen, the fire doesn't like it as much, but by springtime I should be in good shape as far as having this almost ready to go. So I'll give you another update here in a little bit. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is get these are organic potatoes and a carrot left over from in the house, or you know, that I took, because I want to see how they're gonna be able to do in this new garden. Now today is January 30th. The ground is not that heavily frosted, so I can break it up pretty easily. And you know, being that this ground here, I've been putting organic material in here for about 12 years, and it's pretty soft. You can look out across there. I just drive the Bobcat back and forth, and I toss these leaves around, and it's mixed with old plants and old roots. I'm always getting pumpkins growing here, along with peppers show up. Basically, whatever ends up here ends up growing here without me really touching it or knowing it. It never gets watered. It's just a little more rough than I want it to be. So I'm gonna flatten it all out, smooth it all out with the Bobcat. And then I'm gonna put wood chips all over the top of it. And I'm not gonna be tilling it. I'm not gonna water it. I wanna see how it's gonna produce. But anyway, back to these potatoes and this carrot here. They're organic. So I feel safe putting them in the ground here and just see what they do. You know, it's January 30th. Not really supposed to do this kind of stuff now, but nature does it. So I'm gonna do it. I think everything all those big farm companies have been doing is completely opposite than the way nature does it. I mean, I've got all these trees and woods and things all around where nothing's been touched. I've never been in there messing around, yet everything blooms and grows and fertilizes itself, and it's really very healthy in there, but it's never been sprayed. All right, it's never been tilled. When I throw old apples and stuff back there, I see little trees sprouting up. So I'm doing it. To me, much like Paul from that Garden of Eden out in Washington, which I've been learning a lot from, just watching some of his videos, and everything makes sense. Kind of just like what my grandparents used to do over there in Waterford. So I'm doing it. We're gonna put these potatoes and carrot in the ground and see what they look like in the spring, see what happens, see if we get any flowering. I'm gonna put them right over here next to this little, I don't know if this is honeysuckle, I can't remember what this was. I'll know in the spring. But I'm gonna put them right in front of there, and then inside that brush a little bit, I'm gonna lay my logs down long ways with the holes, and right there is where I'm making the homes for the mason bees. They're the best pollinators, and they're native to the states here. So I'm gonna get going on that, and then get going on my fires and getting this place prepped up. Well, something pretty interesting just happened. My neighbor Bob over there, he just came over and asked if I could dig a hole for this deer. This deer we found in the woods between us. It was hit by a car. We don't know how long. I'm not going to take the chance on trying to harvest it, because I don't know how long it's been dead, but it's cold and it's relatively stiff. But I'm just not gonna take a chance on getting sick off it or anything. So if I would have saw it, you know, lay down and die, yep, I would have harvested it and that would have been great. But instead, this is nature's fertilizer. So I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna dig a hole right over here underneath those leaves. It's probably gonna be 2-3 feet deep and it's gonna break down and just be part of the garden. Can't get any better natural fertilizer than that. So it's not all wasted. Too bad it had to lose its life, but I'm not gonna let it sit there and rot and stink and let animals fight over it. So we'll just do the next best thing and use it as natural fertilizer. So that's where it's gonna be, and it's gonna provide later. Thanks again, Bob.